welcome to the 2020-21 graduation ceremony. I will begin our graduation by acknowledging that we are meeting on Aboriginal land that has been inhabited by Indigenous peoples from the beginning. As settlers, we're grateful for the opportunity to meet here, and we thank all the generations of people who have taken care of this land for thousands of years. Long before today, as we gather here, there have been Aboriginal peoples who have been the stewards of this place. In particular, we acknowledge that Central Goma Secondary School is located in the traditional territory of the Anishinaabe peoples. We would like to recognize the Ojibwe people of Fesselon First Nation, who are signatories of the Robinson-Huron Treaty of 1850. We also acknowledge the historic Métis who have traveled through these lands and come to know parts of the Great Lakes as home. We recognize all the original peoples of this territory, past, present, and future, as settlers. This recognition of Indigenous peoples' contributions and historic importance must also be clearly and overly connected to our collective commitment to make the promise and the challenge of truth and reconciliation real in our communities. Greetings to Mr. Colbeck, Ms. McKinney, teachers, staff, and graduates of this school year. Man, what a year it has been! Way back in March of 2020, little did we know we will not enter through the doors of CAS until September, then a repeat in late February 2021, until hopefully September again in the upcoming school year. We have endured many obstacles, from technological problems of online learning to missing our social connections with our friends. We have come to appreciate our support staff for keeping our school clean, and our teachers, past, present, and future, for being there when we have had difficulties in our subjects. I know we all have learned 5 things going through this pandemic, and they are as follows. 1, friends are essential to our mental health. 2, CAS teachers rock. 3, if you have a technical problem, get a hold of Mr. Roon. He knows people. 4, staying home with family 24/7 requires a lot of patience and in your room time. Believe me, I've done it. 5, we are husky strong with immense husky pride, and this is how we persevered. Before the move along with the graduation ceremony, I want to leave you with words from the Academy Award winning song, This Is Us, Now This Is Me, from The Greatest Showman. Won't let them break us down to dust. We know that there's a place for us, for we are glorious. When the sharpest words want to cut us down, we're gonna send the flood, gonna drown them out. We are brave, we are bruised. We are who we're meant to be. This is us. Look out, cause here we come. And we're marching on to the beat we drum. We're not scared to be seen. We make no apologies. This is us. Now, I would like to hand it over to Mr. Maurice. Thank you.
Wina Buju, Akinawiya, Joseph Maurice Indigenous, Wadigong Wanjibayan, Chimigwich Bajayeg Nungong. I start today with a formal greeting in Anishinaabe that is similar to hello everyone and welcome. I am Joe Maurice, Superintendent for the Ogoma District School Board. I come from the place of Rapids, Sault Ste. Marie. On behalf of the Ogoma District School Board, I'd like to congratulate the CAS Huskies Class of 2021. It's a great honor for me to have this opportunity to speak to you today. Today is a day for you to stand tall and to be proud of what you've accomplished over your years of secondary school. The last 16 months have been challenging, and you have demonstrated perseverance in the face of adversity. Today, we're not just delivering diplomas, or delivering a better life for yourselves, your families, and our communities. Education is a journey, and you have reached a major milestone. As you move away from Central Algoma Secondary School, there'll be challenges, opportunities, and successes. As you set sail and set a new course in your life, always remember the roots that give you your wings, including your family, friends, teachers, counselors, coaches, and other mentors in your lives. Be positive, believe in yourselves, and believe that everything is possible once you set your goals. As Mark Twain once remarked, 20 years from now, you'll be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did. So, throw off the bow lines. Sail away from the safe harbor. Catch the trade winds in your sails. Explore. Dream. Discover. As you catch the trade winds in your sails, remember that no matter what your destination, an apprenticeship, college, the workplace, or university, you will each establish your own place in history. And we at the Algoma District School Board look forward to your successes. We are proud of each and every one of you. Congratulations and good luck in your future endeavors. We wish you all the very best. Miigwech.
Good day, and welcome to the Central Algoma Secondary School 2021 graduation. I'd like first to take a moment and acknowledge all the work that went into the production of this graduation video. There were many people who contributed both time and effort. In particular, I want to give a big shout out to Mrs. Foster and her class, who have put in countless hours organizing and planning for what will be a very special graduation. And to Mr. Gallet for his amazing response to our grads, who can now cross the stage because of his effort and selflessness. As well, I would like to thank our superintendent, Joe Maurice, and our trustee, Mr. Rankin, for their support in what has been a challenging year for us all. Welcome to all our staff and parents who may be viewing this virtual graduation production, and most importantly, welcome to our 2021 graduating class. When considering a message to share with the graduating class this year, I thought about Mr. Gallet and how he continued to look for ways to make this graduation special despite all the problems and barriers which he faced, and it caused me to recall the following story. A poor man was once walking down a trail in the hills towards town, accompanied by his favorite horse. As they were making their way, the horse strayed off the path and fell into a deep precipice. So the man attempted to rescue his horse, but no matter how hard he tried to pull, he could not get it out. The man was concerned that there were many predators in the area and didn't want the horse to die a gruesome death, so he decided to bury it. He began to fill the precipice with soil, but as he did so, the horse, rather than allowing himself to be buried, shook off the soil and would step on it. So as the poor man kept filling the hole with soil, the horse kept shaking it off and rising higher and higher in the hole. And before long, the hole was filled and the horse stepped out and started grazing in the adjacent field. So, much like the horse, our graduating class has been faced with many daunting problems, but they haven't allowed themselves to be buried by them. Rather, they have found opportunities to be successful through being creative and resilient, much like Mr. Gallet. Congratulations and well done, CAS 2021 graduating class.
Welcome, graduates. On behalf of the Algoma District School Board, Chair Jennifer Sarlo, myself, and the other trustees of the board, we want to welcome you to this virtual graduation. Again, this year, it's a little different celebration, but just as important, and we want to celebrate your success with you and your families and your friends, and we look forward to the summer break and a time to rejuvenate. It's been a difficult year, the last year, for students and staff, and we hope that you have time over the summer to recover and recuperate and look forward to the fall, whatever that may bring for you, and wish you every success in the coming year. Thank you.
I am not a stranger to the dark. Hide away, they say, 'cause we don't want your broken parts. I learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say, no one will love you as you are. But I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are glorious. When the sharpest words wanna cut me down, I'm gonna send a flood, gonna drown them out. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me. Look out, cause here I come. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum. I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies. This is me.
This is me. hands wrapped around my finger, and it's so quiet in the world tonight. Your little eyelids flutter 'cause you're dreaming, so I tuck you in, turn on your favorite nightlight. To you, everything's funny. You got nothing to regret. I'd give all I have, honey, if you could stay like that. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple. I won't let nobody hurt you. Won't let no one break your heart. No, no one will desert you. Just try to never grow up. Never grow up. You're in the car on the way to the movies, and you're mortified your mom's dropping you off. At 14, there's just so much you can't do, and you can't wait to move out someday and call your own shots. But don't make her drop you off around the block. Remember that she's getting older too. And don't lose the way that you dance around in your PJs getting ready for school. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple. No one's ever burned you. Nothing's ever left you scarred. And even though you want to, just try to never grow up. Take pictures in your mind of your childhood room. What it sounded like when your dad gets home. Remember the footsteps, remember the words said, and your little brother's favorite songs. I just realized everything I have is someday gonna be gone. So here I am in my new apartment in a big city. They just dropped me off. It's so much colder than I thought it would be, so I tuck myself in and turn my nightlight on. Wish I'd never grown up. I wish I'd never grown up. Oh, I don't wanna grow up. Wish I'd never grown up. Could still be living. It'll be simple. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Can stay this simple. Won't let nobody hurt you. Won't let no one break your heart. And even though you want to, please try to never go. Oh, 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 oh. Don't you ever go. Oh, oh, oh. Never go. Just never go.
They say you can't go home again, I just had to come back one last time. Ma'am, I know you don't know me from Adam, but these handprints on the front steps are mine. Up those stairs in that little back bedroom is where I did my homework and I learned to play guitar. And I bet you didn't know, under that live oak, my favorite dog is buried in the yard. I thought if I could touch this place, I'll feel it. This brokenness inside me might start healing. Out here it's like I'm someone else. I thought that maybe I could find myself. If I could just come in, I swear I'll leave. Won't take nothing but a memory from the house that built me. Mama cut out pictures of houses for years, from Better Homes and Garden Magazine. Plans were drawn and concrete poured, nail by nail and board by board. Daddy gave life to Mama's dream. I thought if I could touch this place, so feel it. This brokenness inside me might start healing. Out here it's like I'm someone else. I thought that maybe I could find myself. If I could just come in, I swear I'll leave. Take nothing but a memory from the house that built me.
Hey CAS grads, it's Sadie. Earlier this year, Ms. Foster had sent out a form for all the grads to fill out, which was like most likely to or who is the best at. She had asked me if I'd be able to make this video telling you all of the winners for these awards. Thank you for everyone who participated in making this happen. So the first award is the Best Husky Award, and this one goes out to no one less than Connor Coulter. Connor's always been at all of the sports games cheering everybody on. No matter the score, he's out there cheering for you. Thank you for everything that you've done through all of the teams throughout high school, Connor. This is your award. The next award is the Most Creative Award. This goes to people who you see their artwork around school and you're truly amazed. I can't wait to see what the future holds for you guys. Congratulations, Chandra Russo and Shay McKay. The next one is most likely to be found in the weight room. So this was definitely a hard one for lots of people to answer since this year was not normal whatsoever. When the weight room was open, the person that would be found in there would be Cole Oman. Most talented is the next award. It was given to a girl and a guy for specific things. So the guy who won this was Kala Vikari for running. I'm super excited for him. He is going to UNB next year for a running scholarship. So I can't wait to see where that takes you. And you guys had voted me for dance. And I just wanted to say thank you for everyone who did that. And a big thank you to Miss Anna and Miss Henderson for everything that they've done for me. It wouldn't have been the same if you guys weren't there. The next award goes to Best Dressed. So you see these people walking around school and you know that they were up early, making sure that they always look nice for school. This goes out to Heidi Byman and Aiden Gagne. The Best Laugh. Anybody who knows Lucas Brisson knows he has the best laugh ever. He never fails to lighten up a room and put smiles on people's faces. Congratulations, Lucas. You won this by over 50% of votes. Most likely to succeed is the next award. So this one goes to a girl and a guy who are always super like nice to talk to. They have time to balance school, extracurricular activities, and hanging out with their friends. This goes out to Lauren Stevens and Joelle Lamoureux. You guys are the most likely to succeed. The next award is most likely to be ID'd when they're 30. So this girl who is voted definitely will be ID'd when she's 30. She's really quiet though. Congratulations, Leah Norfolk. The best tractor. This one obviously goes out to Faith and Connor Coulter with their John Deere. The next award is best car. And you know what, Cass? The best car can't actually be a car. It's a black Ford Ranger that normally has a red dirt bike in the back of it. Congratulations, Nathan McCake, too. You won the best car with your Ford Ranger. The next award is most liked by other people's parents. This award goes out to someone who is probably most seen as a role model, someone that parents want their kids to be around. This award goes out to Kala Vikari. The best shoulder to cry on. So I was in a class this year with Miss McDonald and Miss Foster, and this girl always sat there very quietly, making sure that she listened to everything everyone said. She always thought about what she was going to say before she said it in case it hurt someone's feelings. If anybody walked up to this girl and asked to talk to her about something, she would gladly talk to them. Congratulations, Faith Coulter. The next award is most likely to talk your ear off. Being friends with both of these people, I know that that's 100% true, and there's no one better who could have won this award. You walk up to them asking them a simple question and you're there 15 minutes later not remembering why you were there in the first place. Congratulations, Alyssa Grimard and Kira Grizzly. The best bromance. So this one was a funny award. When Miss Foster was looking at all of the answers that she got back from her survey, all of them were Kala Vikari and another guy. So he ended up getting paired with like 6 or 7 different guys. When Miss Foster looked at who he was paired with, it was all people from the basketball team. So congratulations, the boys basketball team from last year. You guys are the best bromance. The next award is the best romance that never was. And it was given to me and my friend Colby. Thanks guys for doing that. Colby and I have been really good friends for a long time, and he's always there to listen to anything I have to say. But yeah, thanks for that. The next one is most likely to break a record, and this is a 3-way tie, which I believe all of them are true. Eric Bites for breaking the clumsiness record, Chandra Russo with skiing, and Kala Vikari for running. And I just wanted to say that Kalavi did break the 3 records at the school for running this year. Most likely to take over the planet. So this guy is a super quiet guy until you get to know him. He definitely has some thoughts in his head that maybe he could take over the world one day. Maybe you should start a little bit smaller than that, but congratulations, Nathan Finley. The next award is the best couponer. So I'm sure everybody has been in a class with this guy. He has a binder full of coupons and he has multiple presentations that he's given lots of us. Congratulations, Connor Coulter, you're the best couponer at CAS. Most likely to be mistaken for Carter Fleming. Congratulations, James, you won that one. Although lots of people did end up putting Nathan Finley, so like, maybe if you guys weren't twins, Nathan would have won that, but congratulations, James. Most inspiring. This is a 3-way tie. All of these people I personally have looked up to, whether it was academics or like sports, looking outside of school from the issues and problems that they've went through. All of these people really deserve this award. Congratulations, Helen Lawrence, Georgia Creor, and Lauren Stevens. Most likely to never change. These are two guys that from the get-go were always funny, always never cared what other people thought about them, and I'm sure they're gonna stay that way forever. Congratulations, David Grexton and Aiden Gagne. And then the last award that I have is most likely to sleep in and miss an exam. This goes to Erica Bites and Chloe Ordo. We all thought that you guys won by a landslide on that one. Keep being you. So that was the end of the awards that I was given. Thank you for everyone who participated. And I just wanted to say congratulations to all of the grads this year. You guys made it through a really tough year, and I'm super proud of everyone. Thanks, guys.
Good evening. I'm Mr. Brown, and tonight I have the honor of introducing your valedictorian. Lauren Stevens is the valedictorian for the graduating class of 2021. Lauren is an accomplished student who is an active member of the student body and intramural program, student council prime minister, and impressed all of her teachers with her dedication and work ethic throughout her high school career. I first met Lauren in my grade 9 business class. She was part of a wonderful and memorable group of grade 9s that year, and tonight I feel so happy and honored to be part of your graduation. I specifically remember Lauren and her core group of friends that year. They were always on task, mostly. Not always quiet, but very positive and always trying to weave in some fun. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, they even somehow convinced me to buy donuts for the entire class to celebrate my wife's birthday. Since then, I have had the pleasure of teaching Lauren in a couple other classes, and each time she demonstrated the same excellent dedication, participation, and kind tenacity. I actually remember talking to Lauren's mom on a couple different occasions about parenting tips for my own kids, because she was such an exemplary student with real maturity and a good sense of humor. I also worked with Lauren running the Cast T-shirt business. Now, although this was not a typical year, she was never afraid to learn a new program and was systematic and reliable in her work. When you see students in roles outside of the classroom, you get a good glimpse of their leadership, their communication with other staff members, their organization, and potentially how they will operate in the work world. I'm confident that Lauren will go on to do wonderful things. She is a supportive friend, an attentive student, an excellent role model, and an awesome representative of this graduating class. Ladies and gentlemen, your valedictorian for the graduating class of 2021, Lauren Stevens.
Good evening, graduates, staff, parents, families, and guests. I am honored to be representing the graduating class of 2021. On behalf of the graduates, I would like to thank you for joining us. Tonight is an opportunity to celebrate our achievements and how far we have come as a class. It is also a chance to recognize that our success is all the more valuable because we have faced unique challenges, unlike any graduating class before us. Despite the circumstances surrounding the last year and a half, we worked to overcome difficulties and continue to accomplish our goals, all the while thinking about how our high school experience is not what we thought it would be. Although unexpected, our experience has brought positive impacts and also a whole lot of inside jokes since we had to stay in our houses. It is my belief that because we graduated amidst a pandemic, we have the skills necessary to solve any problem we may face in the future. This is because when faced with the uncertainty of not only our learning, but many other aspects of our lives, we made the most of what we had and continuously adapted to changes. Switching between online and in-person, asynchronous and synchronous learning required us to, as Friends icon Ross Geller said, pivot. While carrying a couch up the stairs isn't quite the same as following ever-changing restrictions, I think you get my point. We are willing to make those adjustments to keep our community safe while still taking every opportunity to continue learning. I'd like to commend my peers and teachers on their ability to stay positive and work together even while staying 6 feet apart. I would also like to acknowledge our commitment to preventing cohort crossing when our grade had to get out of school several minutes before everyone else. Not that we minded. Let's not forget that our journey together started way back in grade 7. Since then, we have shared many memories together. We have made important contributions to CAS Athletics by proudly participating and succeeding in sports and volunteering our time to the cause. We have shown dedication to our school by working together on Students Council. We have encouraged participation in CAS cafes and shared our talents as well. We've donated time and resources for fundraisers and good causes. We have demonstrated leadership by guiding other students as Link Crew leaders. We have shown excellence in academics and supported our school. These significant moments together are just some of the many things that our class has shared while here at CAS. Being here together for 6 years has allowed us to see how much we really have grown. What seems like only yesterday, but was really 4 years ago, I was standing in front of a crowd in the gym talking about transitioning from grade 8 into high school. At the time, I, and probably many of you, did not really understand just how much we would learn and how many special memories we would make in the coming 4 years. Looking back, it was such an exciting time in our lives. To have grown up with this remarkable group of people is such an honor, and I have no doubts that we will do more great things down the road. Although our time here has come to an end, we will always have our memories and the amazing support of the CAS community as we continue on our own paths. If online school has taught us one thing, it's that it's not always about where we are, but about the people who make our community what it is. Before I close, I'd like to take a moment on behalf of myself and fellow graduates to thank the people that have brought us here. I'd like to thank all the wonderful teachers and staff who have taught us so much. A special thanks to the custodial staff who repeatedly removed the muskrat that kept venturing into our school. I'd like to thank the whole CAS community for being so supportive. To me, I wouldn't be where I am today without all the kindness and friendliness here that makes our school so special. Personally, I'd like to thank my parents, friends, and family who have always encouraged me and motivated me to accomplish my goals. I'd also like to say to the graduates, be proud of how far you have come and good luck in your future endeavors. Congratulations, class of 2021. Thank you.
The kind that lasts a lifetime. Congratulations on all of your hard work. I'm really proud of you guys. I'm going to miss you.
Hi guys, I just want to say congratulations for graduating high school. Yay! You guys are actually my first group of grade nines with me being full-time at Cass. Great group of students, had so many memories with your grade, coaching volleyball, basketball, fantastic group of students. Having you in the classroom with me, great group. You guys are actually the group that pinned me as Rubs, so you gave me my nickname, which is awesome. I just want to say congratulations. You guys will accomplish wonderful things. You guys are a fantastic group of students, and I just want to say you will be missed at Cass. Bye.
Congratulations to all our graduates. We wish you a happy and healthy summer, and good luck on all your new adventures in the fall.
Congratulations, class of 2021. It's been a crazy year. You guys have survived it all. Remember, there's no such thing as luck. Make your own luck. Make your own opportunities. Go out there and get it.
Mr. Brown here. Graduation is always an interesting time. For me, I have mixed emotions. As a teacher, it's sad to see students leave, but at the same time, it's exciting. It's exciting because you have an opportunity to have new challenges, new adventures, new choices, and to meet new people. And it's an exciting moment in your life. So congratulations. We will miss you all.
Hi, grads.
Hi, grads. Congratulations. Foster's here. He just wanted to leave you with some words of encouragement because we think that during this year, having graduated this year, after everything that you guys have been through, you've probably gained these two really important things.
Firstly, I think you're going to be a lot stronger and more resilient as you go through the future.
And the second thing, and I think we're starting to learn this now as we get to go out of our houses and see people again, is to never let a day pass without living it to its fullest extent. And if you can try to do that, you'll live an awesome life. So. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Good luck. Bye-bye.
Grade 12s, you have persevered through the most challenging year I can imagine. Congrats, class of 2021. Now take the plunge.
Hi, graduates. I know that these last couple of years aren't exactly how you planned them, but your perseverance, resiliency, and Cass character shone through in all that you've accomplished. Wishing you all the best as you set sail on your future plans. Congratulations.
Congratulations, grads. You've now successfully completed a grade 12 year. You've been able to demonstrate that you have a growth mindset and that not even a pandemic could slow you down. We wish you all the best. And remember, once a Husky, always a Husky.
Congratulations. You're done. You're done. You're done. Everybody's done.
Congratulations, grads. What a year you had for senior year, but you've made it. We're so proud of you. Congrats.
Congratulations, Cass grads of 2021. You've done a great job and you have an amazing future ahead of you.
To the Cass grads of 2021, I hope that you remember the words of Henry Ford, whether you believe you can or you can't, you're right. Congratulations and good luck.
Hey, Cass grads of 2021, congratulations on making it to this point. Be proud of your accomplishments and the hard work you have put in during your time at Cass. The obstacles that you have faced during this pandemic will only make you stronger in the future. Best of luck with whatever the next steps are. We will miss you at CAS, but you will always be a Husky. Take care, grads. Thanks for helping to make CAS great. Please come back and visit when you can.
Donald, grade 12 graduate, if you're seeing me right now, that means this awesome video is coming to an end. For this, I'm sorry. I'd like to use this opportunity to say congrats to all the grade 12 grads out there for completing high school. It's been tough ever since COVID-19 hit, but we've kept on going and we made it through. You should be extra proud of all the work you've completed since you went through these hard times. I'd also like to use this opportunity to say thank you to the teachers that have taught me over the years, and the teachers I never had a chance to be taught by. Thank you for persevering through these tough times with us. To the parents, we know it must have been hard having a hormonal teenager home every day for the days we had to stay home, so thank you for not going crazy. To my fellow graduates, whether you're continuing your schooling or getting straight to work, I wish you the best of luck.